John. Big John.
Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6 foot six and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.
Big John.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel, Trying Tools 1990. I just want to give you some videos here, or some tools that I've picked up over the years. Show you what they will and will not do, what they're rated for, what they cost, and go from there. Just give you some ideas of tools that you might be looking at to future purchase, or purchase for someone else for a gift, or, you know, just to add to your tool collection or what it might be. I just want to start out by saying that I am not paid by any tool company that you'll see in my upcoming videos. I do not get tools from them. I do not get money from them. I do not get feedback from them. So these are just honest reviews of the tools that you'll be seeing in my upcoming videos. There's no money handed or tools shown or given to me by anybody. With that out of the way, today I want to start off by showing you the Milwaukee Fuel Brushless 12-volt 3/8 Stubby Impact, which is rated for 250 foot-pounds is what Milwaukee's claiming. 250 foot-pounds out of a 3/8, which this is, you know, it's the 3/8 square. That's a good bit for a little gun like this. You know, it's honestly, you know, and you can see my hand, you know, my fingertips. So, you know, it's pretty small for an impact wrench. You know, the little guns like this aren't made to be taking wheels off of, you know, 18 wheelers and, you know, big 3/4 tons or 1 tons. It'll probably do that, but, you know, they're made for, you know, your light duty maintenance work, you know, maybe rotating tires occasionally and stuff like that. But, you know, they're not made for the real big stuff or anything. Like I said, this is the Milwaukee M12 Fuel 12-volt brushless 3/8 stubby impact wrench. The tool only at Home Depot right now is $179, which is item number 2554-20. And Milwaukee does also offer a kit that comes with two batteries and a charger. Comes with 1 2-amp-hour battery and 1 4-amp-hour battery, which is kit 2554-22, which sells for $269 at Home Depot on their website. This impact does offer the three power modes, which is your 1, 2, 3, and 4, and it does offer the fourth mode, which is your auto shutoff mode for loosening and tightening bolts. What I believe is, in that mode, it doesn't let your fastener come the whole way off. So if you're taking just say a lug nut off, it slows the RPMs down as soon as it senses no tension on the fastener. That way it doesn't spin it off. And it also, when you're putting it on, it doesn't over torque it. So it stops probably roughly between 10 to 15 foot pounds, I guess. And it lets you torque it down correctly with the torque wrench from there. Milwaukee is claiming 3,200 impacts a minute and 2,700 RPMs in speed 3. The LED light, and this is the friction ring model. Like I said, it's claiming 250 foot-pounds of torque. The tool itself is coming in right around 2 pounds. The overall width of the tool, so from side to side, Milwaukee is claiming 2 inches. The height from the bottom of the grip to the top of the case here, they're claiming 7 inches. And the depth of the tool from anvil to back, they're claiming to be 5.1 inches. So like I said, it's a reasonably small impact. You know, I don't expect it to be busting lug nuts that have been sitting on a truck loose for, you know, 10, 15 years out in the middle of a field. But, you know, just to rotate your tires or something, it might do that job. you know, but I don't expect it to do what the big guns are supposed to do. This is the brushless model. It's the Gen 2 that has the, like I said, that has the auto shut off mode, which is your symbol down here for the auto shut off. I'll go ahead and put a battery in it. This is the Milwaukee Red Lithium CP 2.0 battery. Just show you what the differences are in them. Like I said, it gives you the LED light, which shuts off momentarily. I'll wait till it shuts off to show you until it comes back on. As soon as you push in the trigger, it'll come back on. You got your forward and reverse switch here, which has very nice detents in it. It's nice and, I don't want to say stiff, but it's the word that I'm going to use. It's not stiff to the point where you can't move it, but it is stiff to the point where you feel the actual detents in it. You can probably hear, you know, the moving of it and everything. It does have the fuel gauge to tell you where your battery's at, which right now this is a fully charged battery, so we're at 4 bars. These clips are nice. I mean, you know, if you're outside working, you know, maybe dragging or putting ring boards on a deck or something and driving lag bolts in with this, you know, you can take that and clip it on your belt. Or, you know, if you're just using this solely in your garage, you just take it off and maybe throw it in your toolbox. And, you know, that way if you ever do need to use it, you have it. We'll go here and show you the different modes. Right now, that's the auto shut off mode, which is this symbol here. Press 1. Which it doesn't, I mean, it turns at a decent speed, but you know, that's probably like for light work. You're taking something apart, maybe, or setting gaskets or something. Speed 2. You know, it does it. You can feel it, you know, you can feel it torque over. It does move your wrist a little bit. And speed 3. You know, that would be for your heavier fasteners, like nuts, bolts, lug nuts, that sort of thing. I just let you look over the tool here a little bit. The LED work lights are nice, you know, if you're out in your driveway doing something and it starts to get dark on you or something, you can still have enough light to finish up what you need to do or see what you need to see. And like I said, this is the 2.0 battery. And they do make these new batteries, which I didn't know about until now, that I think they're 6.0 batteries, but this is a 3.0. I mean, you can see the tool itself with that battery in there sits upright. You know, it sits upright. You know, you don't have to worry about it falling over or anything like that. These smaller batteries, the 2.0s and stuff, the tool doesn't really like to stand up with them. It's kind of top heavy. So, I mean, you can just bump that. I mean, it'll stand, but kind of makes me nervous personally. That's why I kind of like the bigger bottom batteries, so to say, that have that extra width at the bottom here and here. That way they have something stable to sell on. Like I said, this is the 3/8 version with the hog ring, or also a friction ring. They do make this with a pin detent. So instead of having this ring on the end, it'll actually have the pin in the anvil. I haven't seen it or used that model personally myself, but I couldn't imagine it would be much different or hurt the power of the tool, so to say. I got some bolts and stuff here set up that I'm going to torque down here, and then we'll test it a little bit, show you what it'll do, and go from there. Okay, guys, welcome back here. A bolt set up in here now, which is just a standard, just grade 8, 3/4 inch bolt with, I believe this is a, inch and, if I can get it to focus here, 1¼ inch socket. That's what this is, you know, it's just got a washer on it. I'm going to torque this down to 150 foot-pounds. Unfortunately, that's all my cheapy Harbor Freight torque wrench will go to. I'm just going to torque it down on the vise, get some pressure on it, and see if the gun will back it off. So there's 150 foot-pounds. And also, unfortunately, I have to use an adapter, the 3/8 to half. I do not own a 1¼" 3/8 socket, so I know I'm going to lose a little bit by using this to adapt into the socket, but that's all I have at the moment. I'm just going with what I have. So we'll put the adapter in, put that on the gun, and we'll go in speed 3 and see if it'll back it off. Sorry, that was the auto loosening mode. So as you see, it took a little bit. You know, that was 150 foot-pounds. I'll do that again. It took a little bit to get it off of there, you know, but it did eventually take it off. You know, like I said, this is a bigger bolt. You know, we got a 3/4-inch bolt with an 1¼" nut on there. You know, like I said, that is a little bit big of a bolt for this maybe, but, you know, it chugged at it a little bit, but it took it off. I'll do that again so you can see that again. Like I said, this is 150 foot-pounds. I'll show you on the torque wrench. I gotta reposition that in the vise here. It's starting to walk on me a little bit. Try that again and see how it goes. This is speed 3. That time it did it a little bit better. I'm gonna just spin this down by hand just real quick. I'm not gonna put as much pressure on it. I actually might just run it on with the gun just a little bit to show you the auto feature. So as you can see now, if you can't see, I get you in focus here. We're in speed 3, which is this dot over here. I'm gonna put it in the auto feature and let you see how, when it senses no pressure, it slows it down. Oop, gotta put it in reverse. So it slows it down a little bit, but honestly, I don't think that it slows it down enough that you have to worry about it. It might work a little bit better in the fastening mode, which I'll show you also. See how it stopped? It sensed the torque on the bolt, so it automatically stopped. So it works, I guess, okay. I mean, I wouldn't count on it working, but it does what it's supposed to do. You know, it stopped how, you know, they explained it to. So, you know, I guess it's okay for what it is. I'm actually going to take these bigger bolts out. I have some 5/8 that I'm going to throw in here. Now, these are the same thing. These are just a regular 5/8 bolt. Grade 8. They got a lock washer on them. It's just what I had laying around. Nothing special. Get my bolts out of the way here. And I'm only going to torque this one down this time. I'm going to just torque it down to 120. That way it's not beating on the gun as bad. Being that this is the little guy, I mean, it's not, like I said, I wouldn't put this on a service truck and take it out on service calls and depend on it to bust 150, 200 foot-pounds loose all day. So, like I said, those ones, those bigger ones, if I can get it in focus here, those were 150 foot-pounds. Actually, 151, so to say. But I'm going to back this off this time to just 120. Okay. So, we're at 120 foot-pounds. I'll get that in focus for you. 120. Which honestly, that's what your, you know, your lug nuts and stuff on a half ton, that's about the max that they should be torqued to. You're not going to see much more than that on a half ton. They get up into the 3/4 tons and stuff. You might see a little bit more than that. I'm sure you will. But like I said, this gun ain't made to do that big stuff. Will it? Probably to get you out of a pinch. But it's not something I would depend on daily. And this is a 1 5/16. And we're going to go at that in speed 3 also. So as you see, it spun it right off. No problems. We'll torque it down again, show you again. Like I said, this is 120 foot-pounds. Try it in speed 2 and see if it takes that off at 120. Nah, it's not going to do it. We'll have to bump it up to speed 3. And this is a fully charged battery also, as you can see. I mean, 120 foot-pounds on speed 2, it just don't want to move it. So, speed 3, took it right off, no problem. I'll show you the spin-in mode, how it shuts off on the smaller one. See? It closed the gap up. So, I mean, as soon as it senses the torque on the fastener, it stops. Which is kind of nice. That way, if you are doing lug nuts or something, or a job that needs torque specific, you don't over-torque it and have to back it back off. See? So, it stopped. So, I mean, the 250 foot-pounds, you know, if you let it hammer and hammer and hammer and hammer on something, it would probably take 250 foot-pounds off, but my opinion, just, you're beating the tool up, you know. It is made for it, but, you know, at that point, you might just want to consider either putting a, you know, a breaker bar on it or something to get it popped loose, or, you know, possibly, you know, if you have stuff that you're constantly going to be doing over that, it might be worth your time to step up to maybe like their mid-torque or their high-torque model, which I have and will be doing in later videos to show you that model. I'm going to reposition the camera here and just show you how it'll drive a lag screw, lag bolt, whatever you want to call it. Get it in focus here. If I can. So, okay guys, sorry about that. I don't know what happened when I went to do the lag bolt. It kind of, my camera shut off on me. I'm gonna back this out and run it back in again. We're on speed 3. So, I mean, it ran it out, no problem. I'm just gonna run it back in again so you can see. And again, this is on speed 3. So, I mean, you can see it had no trouble driving that. That's just a 3/8 or a 1/4 inch, probably about 4 or 4.5 inches long. That's what I would be mostly using this for if I was using it in the construction field, you know, driving lag bolts or cement fasteners, you know, anchoring a post to cement or, you know, stuff like that. You know, the lag bolts would be one thing. If I was using it in like a garage setting or something, you know, as a technician, you know, it'd be good for your light maintenance work, you know, brakes, rear ends, you know, that sort of things. I wouldn't be trying to bust, you know, leaf springs loose with it or nothing, but, you know, taking rear ends apart and axles out and whatnot, it'd be fine. The overall quality of the tool itself is great. You know, the rubber overmolding is real nice. As you can see, there's no sharp edges on it or nothing. The trigger and the light are excellent. I mean, there's really no delay with it coming on. The aluminum up here is real nice. You know, it's got the powder coat finish on it. The anvil itself, I'll leave that socket on. It's also, the friction ring is really nice. You know, you're not going to hit that and have it fall off on you or anything. You know, you kind of actually have to pull the socket off there. The anvil is real nice. There's no burrs or, you know, machining marks on it or nothing. So the overall quality of the tool is nice. The plastic's real nice. You know, put up to a 6 amp hour battery on here. I believe that's the biggest they make for the 12 volt lines now. So I mean, overall, it's a nice little impact. Kind of fills the void between, you know, the real big ones and the you know, your ratchets and stuff, so to say. I'm gonna position this camera one more time here. I got an old tractor. I'm gonna show you taking lug nuts off of that, and then just wrap it up. All right, guys, we got the old 54 Farmall Super C here. Got the wheel lugs and stuff on here, which are just the standard 5/8 bolts that they go through the wheel itself, and then you can see they go through into the hubs there, which have a nut on the back. I'm gonna replace this camera so you can see this. I'm just going to spin one of these off and see how it does on those. I believe I torqued those to 120 foot-pounds. So, nothing crazy, but you know, just to show you what it will do. That's all. Make sure you can see this here. Sorry if it's kind of shoddy. This is my first video. Gotta get the adapter. Again, we're gonna do this on speed 3. As you see, took that off no problem. Now I'm putting it back on, it's the same thing. Lost my lock washer. And we'll just put it back on. So, light maintenance work, you know, the occasional lug nuts and whatnot, it'll do okay with. You know, the bigger stuff, I would either hold out for the mid-torque or the high-torque model. That way you're not beating the tool up too bad, and you know that you have the power there to do the job that you need to do. Like I said, overall quality of the tool is really nice. The batteries are really nice. You know, it is a 12 volt model with 3/8 anvil on it. And again, it's the stubby 3/8. If you guys like this video and you'd like to see more, please like and subscribe to the channel. Have any comments or anything that you'd like to see if it'll do, please leave it in the comments. I will definitely try to get to it. Other than that, guys, I mean, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. Don't forget to like the video if you do, and please subscribe to the channel. Thanks, guys. I look forward to showing you some more stuff. Have a great evening. Big John.
Big John. Every morning at the mine, you could see him arrive. He stood 6'6" and weighed 245, kind of broad at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. And everybody knew you didn't give no lip to Big John.